What is healthy heart? Healthy heart is a condition which is defined as an adequate functioning and structurally normal heart. In lay terms, if you are able to complete your work without dyspnea, without chest pain, or undue restlessness, or undue weakness, then you can assume that you are having healthy heart. If you do not have any syncope, giddiness, dizziness, or any edema, that is swelling of your feet, then that implies that probably you are having healthy heart. But still, we do not know that if there is a underlying disease is running out in your heart or not. For that, you need to get yourself periodically tested if you are more than 40 years of the age. What is heart attack? Why a person does get heart attack? Heart attack is a condition in which blood supply to the heart is stopped in a particular region because of the blockage in one of the arteries which is supplying blood to the heart. It usually happens because of the excessive cholesterol deposition, which leads to partial blockage, and on the partial blockage there is a thrombosis. In heart attack, patient usually gets the chest pain. Chest pain can be anywhere between upper part of the abdomen till the jaw. So if you are getting undue chest pain, which increases on exertion, or if it is associated with sweating, then you should consult your doctor immediately. The next question comes, whether chest pain, all type of the chest pain, are related to heart. It is not. In the chest, there are many other structures like bone, like lungs, pleura, which can give rise to the pain. But it is very important to know that this pain is from the heart or not, because heart pain can be life-threatening condition. So to know, one should contact doctor, and he will do certain tests to ascertain whether it is from the heart or not. These tests are very simple, like getting your blood sugar, cholesterol levels, ECG, X-ray chest, treadmill test, and echocardiograms. Sometimes, if we say that a person is has a heart disease, then it is usually assumed that he has a heart attack. It is not only heart attack which affects the heart. There are many more other conditions which do affect the heart. That is the hypertension. There can be disease of the valves. Valves are the structure which permit only one-sided blood flow in the heart, and there can be leakage in the valve, or there can be blockage in the valve, which can lead to certain type of diseases. Then there can be disease of the structure which is covering the heart, that is pericardium. Then there can be disease of the related arteries, that is congenital heart disease, which can arise right from the birth itself. There can be hole in the heart. So it is not only the heart attack which affects the heart, but there are many more diseases. And if you get any symptoms, then contact your doctor, who will be able to diagnose the disease, which type of disease it is. There is other diseases as well, like heart can go weak, heart can beat abnormally. That is also related to the heart. In my practice, it is usually asked to me that it was very surprising that this patient had heart attack. He was very well. He was running around. He was going for 3 kilometers walk. He neither smokes, nor he is diabetic, nor he is hypertensive. To remind you, these are the conditions which increases the chances of getting heart attack. If a person do not possess these predisposing risk factors, then also he is he can have an heart attack, and but the chances are less. Heart attack happens because of the gradual clogging of the blood vessels which supply blood to the heart, and that can even happen asymptomatically. So that is why these patients are usually asymptomatic, but when the artery is completely occluded, they get an heart attack. Many of my patients ask, it's end of the life, oh, I have an heart attack. That is not. In my view, even life after heart attack can be normal if you follow three basic rules. That is, your diet should be proper, you should go for proper exercise, and then you should regularly take your prescribed medicines on time, each time, and you should get a follow up with the doctor whosoever is near to you, or with whosoever doctor you are following, you should be regular with that doctor. So it is diet, exercise and medicine. With all three we can defeat the heart problem, heart attack, and we can lead a normal life. If I have to say how to live, what to do to be in a lower risk for the heart attack or in a lower risk for any other disease, I will rather say have a balanced diet, go for regular exercise, that is very important. Do not go for junk foods. Quit smoking or tobacco product, whatever way you are using. Anything in excess is bad. So if you are using alcohol, do it in moderation, it's better to leave it. And use lot of fruits, fresh vegetables in your diet to improve the nutrient and nutritional content of your diet.